Hi, and welcome to NC State's Department of Horticultural Science. My name is Lis Meyer, and I'm a senior lecturer here. I'm also an alum of this department. So right now, I'm standing in a garden area that was installed and designed by our students in a class here. And what I'd like to do now is just take you on a short tour on some of the spaces you'll be using during your time here. This is Kilgore Hall. It's the main building for horticultural science at NC State, so you'll be spending a lot of time here. We've just entered Kilgore from the door that faces Hillsborough Street, which puts you on the first floor. The first floor is where all of our classrooms are, as well as most of your professors' offices. However, we also have many of those on the second floor, as well as the research laboratories and the graduate student lounge. So without further ado, let's take a look at some of our classrooms on this floor. This is 103 Kilgore Hall. It's one of our classrooms, and all of our lecture classrooms on the first floor have been newly renovated. So this just gives you an idea of where you'll be. If you take any landscape design classes, you'll find yourself in a room like this one. So we have drafting tables for you to work on, and of course, an area for you to present and discuss designs with your classmates and your professors. So the first two offices you'll encounter if you come in the door that we just came in are two people that are very important to know if you're an undergraduate. So this 116 Kilgore is the office of Isaac Lewis. He's our undergraduate coordinator assistant. Over here in 114 Kilgore Hall is Dr. Helen Krause's office. And Helen is our undergraduate coordinator. If you're a graduate student, you're definitely gonna wanna know about this office. This is room 122, and it's the office of Rachel McLaughlin. She's the graduate programs assistant, and she knows everything that you could possibly need to know about graduate programs. Also important to note, Rachel and Isaac always have a bowl of candy in their office. Another important student organization that we have in our department is Pi Alpha Xi, or PAX as most people call it. So this is an honorary horticulture society that's a national society, or the IOTA chapter, so the ninth one established in the US. And it's existed here at NC State since 1957. So if you're a graduate student, or for some juniors and seniors in our department, you can be inducted into PACS. We're a service organization, so every year we have two big plant sales at the North Carolina Museum of Art, and all of our profits are donated to local charities and nonprofits. This is the Graduate Student Lounge. It's been newly renovated, and it's so nice that I'm a little bit jealous. So there's a common area here, a kitchen behind me, and also individual desks and some collective offices for graduate students. Inside the graduate student office, there are lockers for personal storage, and each student will have their own locker. Additionally, there's a printer and copying machine for grad student use in this area. This is one of the graduate student offices. Each graduate student will have their own desk. They are adjustable, so you can stand or sit at your desk as you wish. This is the second graduate student office on the second floor of Kilgore. So just like the other one, there are desks for students as well as lockers for storage. If you find yourself here in the basement, you might wonder what exactly you've wandered into. But this is the basement level of Kilgore Hall, and there are a few things you want to know about here. If you're an undergraduate, there is another design studio here that you may have class in. If you're a graduate student, there are several research labs on this level. We've just entered the first floor of the Marianne Fox Building. Our greenhouses and a lot of our lab classrooms are in this building, but counterintuitively in the basement. So the first thing you should do on entering this building is to go downstairs. Here in the basement of Fox, the first place you'll encounter most likely is the head house, and a lot of the labs for your classes will be held here using these benches. This classroom is Fox B21, so if you have a class in Fox, it's gonna have that B in front of the room number so you know it's in the basement. This is the wet lab. So some labs that are held here include plant propagation, which is my class, as well as others that use the equipment here. There's one other classroom in the basement of Fox that we use, which is just down the hall from this. That's Fox B31, and you may have classes in there as well. These are the Fox greenhouses, and specifically, we're currently in one of the conservatory greenhouses. Now you're still accessing these from the basement, as weird as that may seem. So we have two conservatories that are usually open during normal business hours. This is the Tropical Plant Conservatory. It's maintained by Diane Mays, our greenhouse technician, and it's also a place where you may come for class and also do an internship with Diane in taking care of the plants in this area. This is our second conservatory. This is the one that houses our arid region plants as well as carnivorous plants. As you enter it, you'll see on the door the letter B, because we're currently in the B range, which refers to this whole row of connected greenhouses. The Tropical Plant Conservatory is in the A range. So when you come into the greenhouses for class, make sure you pay attention to those letters in the doors, as they'll help you navigate around. This is the Horticulture Field Lab, or HFL, as you'll usually hear it referred to. The hands-on component of education is really important in our department, and this area lets us do just that. So if you're an undergraduate student, you'll likely have labs out here for some of your classes. If you're a graduate student, you'll probably be spending a lot of time here doing your research, whether it's outside or in the greenhouse complex behind me. We also have a classroom in that greenhouse complex that you may be using for some of your classes. I'm still at the Horticulture Field Lab, but this is our teaching projects area. So if you take a landscape construction class or something similar to that, chances are you'll be out here. Again, this is a good place to have that hands-on experience. So this arbor behind me was built by students in one of our classes. All the pavers have been laid by students in our classes, and the pond, which is through the arbor, was also built by them as well. So it's definitely a good chance to get real-world experience in the things that you're learning in the lecture hall. One of the best things about our department is having access to the J.C. Ralston Arboretum. It's a nationally acclaimed collection of plants and one of the most diverse ones in the southeastern United States. Sometimes you'll come here for class, but whenever it's open, you're welcome to come walk around and spend a little quality time with your friends, the plants.